He is immortal. Born in the Highlands of Scotland 400 years ago, he is not alone. There are others like him. Some good, some evil. For centuries, he has battled the forces of darkness, with holy ground his only refuge. He cannot die unless you take his head and with it his power. In the end, there can be only one. He is Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander.
What do you think? You think he could take it?
Sure.
Oh, yeah? Let's go. Tell me, do you feel it in your gut? Tell me, what's it like to die?
I cannot believe that we are turning down front row, standing room only tickets to this country's most souped-up road monsters in the ultimate battle of motocross supremacy that I personally, me, Richie Ryan, scalp at $50 a pop to look at some pictures.
I'm meeting an old friend.
Oh. Wait, old as in,
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Hey, don't worry. We'll be back before the first race.
Well, that I think I can live with.
Thanks, guys.
After you people. This stuff is extreme.
Extremely violent. They haven't labeled any yet. Which ones are his?
Who knows? Never seen any of Gregor's work. Didn't even know he was a photographer until he called.
This one I could hang in my living room.
Something familiar about it.
Well, 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 if it isn't a Highlander himself.
Gregor. You haven't changed a bit. Except maybe for the fashion statement.
Well, looks can be deceiving.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Tessa.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Call me Greg, though. Greg has such an old-fashioned ring to it.
And a good friend of mine, Richie.
Hey. Good.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
We're going to look around.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Excuse us.
Nice. Do they know?
What do you think?
You were always one to lay it on the line.
Yeah. Where the hell have you been?
Here, there, everywhere.
So, when did you start being a photographer?
Yeah, I'm playing at it for quite some time now.
I'd say you've been doing a little more than playing. This is a high-profile show.
Yeah, somebody must have made a mistake, huh? What do you think?
That's beautiful.
It's not one of mine. This is...
Oh, this is yours.
You don't like it?
Oh, no, it's just a little dark for my taste.
Yeah, well, I'm just showing it like it is, you know?
Yo, Mac. Mac, come here, check this out. Look at this. Hey, Greg, bet this one's one of yours, huh?
No.
No? You're kidding.
Oh, God, are you okay? Oh, I'm so sorry.
I'm all right.
You should have someone take a look at that hand.
I will.
You can tell a lot about a man by his hands.
Is that so?
I'm Linda Plager. Why'd you do that?
Do what?
Run into the burning building.
Because that's where the fire was?
Very funny.
What are you, a reporter?
Freelance photographer. You know, crime scenes, fatal accidents, star divorces, who's doing what to whom and how often.
The more gruesome, the better.
Hey, everybody's got to be somewhere. Come on, don't you want to be a hero?
Ooh, no thanks.
What's with you? It's what people want to see.
Because that's all you show them.
Oh, maybe I should try and sell the editor pictures of flower vases, kittens playing, freshly baked pies.
Your camera sees what you want it to see. You can shoot hope or despair, garbage or flowers. It all depends on where you want to spend your life. Right.
Hey, wait up. How come you know so much?
How come you don't?
Oh, wait, wait.
Duncan? It's you. How did you find me? Where have you been all these years? This is Duncan MacLeod, the one I told you about.
Now, Miss Plager, this is a young man. I'm terribly sorry, it's her medication.
I'll medicate you in a minute. This is Duncan. Without him, I'd still be shooting garbage. You never mind her. She'll call an ambulance if I sneeze. We have so much to talk about.
You know what Dr. Reitman said about wearing yourself out.
I'm telling you, that's Duncan.
You know Linda Plager?
That is the Linda Plager?
Oh, yeah.
I've only seen her work in books.
She's a real thing, man. This show is for her.
Never thought I'd see her again.
Wait a second. This means that you're her long-lost benefactor? And all this time, I thought you were at the right place at the right time.
Just had no idea.
Oh, she's a big deal, man. All of her work's gonna be worth a fortune in a few weeks.
Why?
One of the old ladies dying.
This stuff excites you, MacLeod.
What was that?
Never mind.
Sorry, I was just thinking.
About Linda.
Yeah.
Are you going to tell her?
Tell her what?
That she was right about you.
Why would you want to do that?
Because the woman is dying.
That's right. What's the point? She's gone on this line without knowing. Of course, I'm just playing devil's advocate.
I don't know what I'm going to tell her. But I have to tell her something. I'll see you at home. See ya.
He really cares about you. You're both lucky.
Yeah.
Must be hard knowing that you'll keep getting older in MacLeod. I mean, tell me, how do you handle knowing that one day he's gonna watch you grow old, wrinkle, and then die, and eventually move on to somebody else?
Were you born sensitive, or did you have to study?
Hey, come on, I didn't mean anything by it. I'm just curious, that's all.
Hot dogs for everybody. Have a dog, Tess. Enjoy a dog, it's
all
me.
I think I'm going home. I'll see you later, okay?
That was weird.
Well, she's a woman, you know what I mean, Richie?
Tell me about it.
Miss Plager?
I'm sorry. I was on another planet. Would you stop hovering? I'm fine.
Miss Plager, what is it?
Nothing. Maybe I shouldn't have spoken so soon. I think I'd like to go home and rest. What? Call an ambulance.
So, how long have you known Mac?
Long time.
Listen, there's something I always wanted to ask another immortal about him.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Well, in all the time that you've known him, 200 years, right? Has he changed a lot?
We all change.
Yeah, I mean, but how?
How do you change?
Well, that's not the same. I mean, you know, I just get older. Change is inevitable.
What if you didn't get any older? Then how would you feel?
Well, Greg, I probably wouldn't feel anything. I'd be dead.
What if you were one of us?
An immortal? Are you kidding? That'd be fantastic. I mean, the places I'd go, things I'd do, the women I'd...
Barry?
What'd you say?
Nothing important. You know, immortality is not as all it's cracked up to be.
Yeah, well, it's easy for you to say. You're gonna live forever.
Am I? I don't know.
At least you got a shot at it.
It's a comforting thought. You afraid of death, Richie?
Absolutely. Aren't you?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Hi.
Hello. I feel like such an idiot. I realize now, of course, you couldn't be. I'm sorry. I seem to have trouble catching my...
It's okay.
My hand is strong. Reminds me of his. That's what I first noticed about him. He burnt one of them in a fire. You're related to him, aren't you? Did he ever mention me?
Yes, he did.
It's because of him. Of what he taught. To look for the light instead of the shadows. I never realized how much he meant to me. How much I loved him.
He knows.
It's over.
Why?
Because I love you.
Oh, that's a good reason.
Don't you understand? You've made me see that I can be something more than a sleazy photographer. That my work can move people. Inspire them.
This is bad?
No, it's not bad. It's wonderful. But I can't handle you and my work at the same time.
I'm not asking you to.
You don't have to. Just having you around kills my concentration. Whenever I see something beautiful, instead of thinking, where's my camera, I think, where's Duncan?
You don't have to choose.
Yes, I do. If you don't leave right now, I may never be able to ask you again.
Whatever you say.
Why do I think I just made the worst mistake of my life?
Duncan?
I'm gonna make you proud of me.
You look just like him. It's uncanny. My parents died so long ago. I have no children. Does it seem funny for an old woman to want someone to be proud of her?
No.
If only...
He's very proud of you. I'm very proud.
So you didn't tell her?
Tell her what? That eternal life does exist, but not for her?
Duncan, how close were you?
Does that matter?
No. But you never told her about...
Being immortal? No. I only told you.
Hey, guys. Ooh. I'm sorry.
It's all right. Where's Gregor?
Yeah, I went to run a couple of errands. Listen, I'm gonna go to the studio and check it out later. Is that cool?
Yeah.
I mean, who knows? Maybe photography is in my future. I'll see you later.
Richie, be careful.
Yeah. Sure. Later.
Something wrong?
Tell me more about Gregor. I mean, what kind of person is he? He just said some things.
He made you feel uncomfortable.
He's not the way you described him. And all those pictures.
Well, maybe he's grown a thicker skin since I knew him.
Breathe now.
You got a weird sense of humor.
Maybe it wasn't a joke. It was a test.
A test? What for?
To see if you were real or just McCloud's shadow.
Go to hell.
Richie, it's too easy to push your button.
Look, it's been fun. I'll see you around.
Hey, Richie. Think you can ride? You know how to ride a bike?
I don't know. Maybe. I think I can fake it.
Jonathan couldn't hack it. He just didn't have the stuff.
What is this? Some sort of initiation?
You could say that.
Lead the way, my friend.
Russia, what? You made it, man. I bet you thought it was over for sure.
Lay off me. Come on, what are you pissed at me for? I could have killed myself, that's why.
Richie, would I have let you do it if it was dangerous?
Oh, man, look at this.
You just need a couple of stitches, that's all. Let's go. I don't want McCloud thinking I'm abusing his best buddy.
Was that Richie?
No, it wasn't. I was just checking in with the hospital.
How is she?
The same. What's going on?
Well, we had a little bit of an accident, but nothing to worry about.
What happened to your arm?
It's no big deal. I dumped a bike.
Dumped a bike? Whose bike?
Mine. No damage, though.
No damage. That's no damage.
I'm okay, Mac.
I didn't realize you were the boy's father. Later.
Richie's arm is fine. Don't sweat it.
Yeah, but what's going on, Greg? What's with all these games?
Take it easy. I think you're letting these mortals get a little too much under your skin. I mean, look at this Linda Plager thing. You're beating yourself up over what's obviously a pretty much cut-and-dried situation.
You of all people.
People, McCloud, is that what we are? Are we really still people? Are we really supposed to care about them, care about anything?
Well, tell me what else there is if we don't.
Take a look at me and see for yourself.
So you don't care about anything?
I'm right here, man. Search me.
What happened to you? Huh?
Life happened to me, my friend. Eternal life, to be exact. Sort of ironic, isn't it?
I call it tragic.
You think so? I don't know, I feel sort of privileged. I mean, it's a lot easier to get through time without all the crap that humans carry around with them to drag you down.
Oh, you mean things like feelings, compassion, love. You've done away with all those things.
I don't know. It's just a long time since I checked.
You feel nothing?
Not even for myself.
It's funny because I don't believe you. Your pictures are not the work of a man that feels nothing. Don't tell me you don't care about them. The opium sauce from Indian Wells. Out of dooms and good.
Bring him over here.
How's Billy?
What am I gonna tell Ray?
That you did what you could.
I watched him die is what I did.
You don't wear miracles, Gregor. You're a doctor. If you keep beating yourself up.
Where's my boy, Gregor? Where's my boy?
Ray, I'm sorry. I did everything I could.
No. No, he ain't dead.
There's nothing I could do.
He wasn't that sick when I brought him here.
It was cholera, Ray.
No, no, it was a small fever. He killed my boy, Quaker. You murdered my son.
Let's go outside.
No!
No!
My God, what have I done?
Go home.
My boy.
Go home. Send him home. I'll talk to the sheriff. Tell him it was an accident.
I can't go back, can I?
Nope. You're dead to him. Time to move on.
I can't do this anymore. Anything I do, they'll die. How do you go through the years? All your friends.
One day at a time.
So how's your friend?
He's not happy with his life.
What did he say?
He's lost.
What do you mean, lost?
He doesn't know who he is anymore.
Sounds like he needs therapy.
That's easier said than done. Imagine going into somebody and saying, "Hello, I'm Duncan MacLeod, and I've grown a little neurotic over the past 400 years, and I'd like to talk to you about it." They'd lock you away.
Richie could have been badly hurt.
Yeah, I know.
He scares me, Mac. I've got this feeling he didn't care.
He's not evil, Tess.
How do you know?
Because he's my friend. Anyway, what do you want me to do? Chop off his head?
No. I just wish he'd go away.
Shine, shine, shine.
Let me call you back, okay? I'll talk to you soon, okay? Hello?
Where's McCloud?
Greg, he went to the hospital for a few minutes. He'll be right back. You're welcome to hang out.
I've hung out a little too damn long as it is. I destroyed them all. And I didn't feel a thing. I guess it's true what they say about a life's work. But then again, maybe I'd feel differently if my life was going to be over at some point.
You destroyed what? The photographs?
Everything. The photographs. Why not? Answer me that and you win the playoffs. You don't want to win the playoffs. At the edge of the bridge. Just before liftoff. Fear, right? Then what? For me, nothingness.
Well, I guess I don't know what I feel.
That's because you can feel, boy. Want to know what it feels like to die?
No. Greg, please.
I could send you to the grave in a heartbeat and I wouldn't feel a thing. Because I don't know how. I destroyed them all and I didn't feel a thing.
Gregor, this has to end.
But I'm having such a good time. Are you having a good time?
Leave her out of this.
You live with what you are!
Die, or you can change, but you can't go on living the way you are.
Go ahead. Do it!
How did it feel? It's gonna be all right, my friend. How you feel?
Like an old photograph. Faded around the edges. But the essence of the person is still in it.
It's funny you should say that.
It's wrapped beautifully. Want to turn your head while I tear it to shreds? I was always too anxious when it comes to presents.
Yeah, I remember. Go ahead.
Grandfather, give this to you.
No. You did.
Duncan.
Don't ask me to explain, Linda. It's not something you need to understand now. What you need to understand is that you've always been very important to me.
It's not the first time I've imagined this.
No, Linda, it's not your imagination. I wanted to tell you the first time I saw you in the gallery. I'm so proud of you. Always have been. Hey, tell me. Tell me you believe me. You have to believe me.
Even though I never took pictures of kittens and flower vases.
Or freshly baked pies.
I should never have left you. I was so young.
And beautiful. And talented. You still are.
Thank you, Duncan. so much for everything.
Please whisper.